Let's go back a few years to the incident at Boat Pack 3. According to your report, you and Chief O'Brien crash-landed on the planet, where you then made contact with a group of Jem'Hadar.
We didn't make contact with them. They captured us.
Well, if that's the case, why didn't you attempt to escape?
We didn't have a chance.
According to Chief O'Brien, you were more interested in curing the Jem'Hadar of their addiction to Ketracel White.
I'm a doctor. They were suffering from withdrawal.
They're the enemy. Genetically engineered killing machines.
They're not machines, they're sentient beings, and I couldn't just stand there and watch them die.
Why? Because you felt sympathy for them, being genetically engineered yourself.
This is irrelevant. We're talking about an incident that happened before Dr. Bashir allegedly became a Dominion agent.
It's not irrelevant, Captain. If anything, it shows he was already sympathetic to the Dominion. But let's move on. Doctor, we spoke yesterday about a group of genetically enhanced patients that you brought to the station. Why exactly did you decide to work with them?
They've been institutionalized most of their lives. I thought I might find a way to help them assimilate into society.
A laudable goal. What I find puzzling is the way you went about it. These misfits had been sheltered from the outside world for as long as they could remember. Yet you chose to bombard them with information about the war with the Dominion. Frankly, I'm surprised it didn't scare them into a deeper isolation.
I wanted to engage them, and it worked.
Is that why you convinced Starfleet Command to give them access to classified battle plans?
Starfleet was interested in hearing our ideas on how to win the war.
How to win the war? You recommended that the Federation surrender.
We were looking for ways to save as many lives as possible. Now, if you take the time to examine the findings...
Captain, you took the time to examine the findings, didn't you?
I did.
And did you agree with them?
No.
Of course not. No loyal Starfleet officer could.
I won't deny that Dr. Bashir has made some questionable decisions in his career. But that's a long way from convincing me that he is a traitor. Now, so far, your case is based on circumstantial evidence and speculation.
What other kind of case can I make against a man who covers his tracks so well?
That's a circular argument, and you know it!
Captain! If Dr. Bashir had been involved in one or two questionable incidents, I could understand how you might be able to dismiss it. But the sheer number of incidents form a pattern of behavior that can't be ignored. I understand you want to be loyal to a man who's served under you for so long. I understand you'd be inclined to take his word over that of an outsider. But step back for a moment and think about it. This man concealed the truth about his illegal genetic enhancement for over 30 years. He lied to get his medical license. He lied to get into Starfleet. He lied to you when he came aboard this station, and he's been lying to you ever since.
He did eventually come forward and tell the truth.
That's right, he did. Why? Why? What made you confess? Was it because you realized that it was your duty to be honest with your captain?
No.
Was it because you felt guilty for having lied to him for so long?
No.
Then why did you come forward?
I was found out.
And if you hadn't been found out, would you have come forward and told your captain the truth? Ever?